Solve the equation on the interval 0 through 2 pi. 2 cosine square theta plus 3 sine theta equals 0. So we got two types of trig functions. So the first thing we need to do is change in terms of only one type of trig function. So we can change cosine into sine or sine into cosine. And the relationship between sine and cosine is, we know that sine squared plus cosine squared is 1. So it's easier to change cosine squared into sine, which is sine squared. So if we subtract sine squared from both sides, we get cosine squared is 1 minus sine squared. Okay, we don't have formula for sine. Okay. There will be, but that's more complicated. So we want to change cosine square as 1 minus sine square. So 2 times quantity 1 minus sine square theta plus 3 sine theta equals 0. Let's distribute. We get 2 minus 2 sine square theta plus 3 sine theta equals 0. Now we put this in standard order, that means sine square first, then sine, then constant. So negative 2 sine square theta first plus 3 sine theta and 2, that's plus 2. So whenever we have negative in the front, we can always multiply both sides by negative 1 just to get rid of this negative sign. So multiply both sides by negative 1, so negative, negative, positive. So we have 2 sine square theta. This becomes negative 3 sine theta. This becomes minus 2 equals negative 1 times 0 is 0. So we have an equation with only one type of trig function, which is sine. So let's do side work. If we assume x b sine theta, let x be sine theta, then this becomes 2x squared minus 3x minus 2 equals 0. Now we want to factor this trinomial. 2x squared, the only way it factors is 2xx. Now 2, that will be 2 times 1 or 1 times 2. And we have to get negative 3. So 2 times 2, 2 times 2, 4, and to get negative, negative 4, and negative 2 is now 2 times 1, and it becomes positive. So FOIL these two binomials to check the factoring is good, okay? If you FOIL these two factors, then you get back here. So from this factor, you get x equals 2 using the zero factor property. Times from this factor you get x equals plus 1 over negative 1 over 2. So that is, in our case, x is sine theta, so this implies sine theta equals negative 1/2, or x equals 2 means sine theta equals 2. It's kind of clear. Sine theta or cosine theta, their values lie in between negative 1 and 1. So this is bigger than 1. So there is none. There is no theta possible. So in this case, from this, no theta. Or there is none. No solution, by the way. Because we cannot find any angle. No solution. Here in the first equation, sine theta equals negative 1/2. So sine has negative value. If we look at the quadrant rule, sine is negative here in the third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Okay, without negative, that would be the reference angle in the first quadrant. 1/2 sine of sine 30 degrees, sine pi over 6. Okay, sine pi over 6 is 1/2. But we need the angles in these quadrants. So pi over 6. 5 pi over 6, 7 pi over 6, and 11 pi over 6. So these two are the correct angles for us. So theta equals 7 pi over 6 and 11 pi over 6. No solution, so this is it.